Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So I'm gonna teach you today how to calculate the dew point of a multi-component mixture and as well as find its liquid mole fractions. Now in my previous videos I just taught you how to calculate the bubble point. However, dew point is nothing different and nothing too much different. So what is it is that we have a vapor mixture here. There is, let's say for example, air. It's a mixture of nitrogen, oxygen. So at a certain temperature, the vapor will start to condense around the container and it will form liquid droplets. So the temperature at which the first drop or the first dew forms, it's like in leaves, when air condenses on leaves, you find dew. So that's where the name comes, dew points. So the temperature at which the first droplet of liquid forms, that is called the dew point temperature. Now what they've given over here, since we have an already present gaseous mixture, these mole fractions are vapor mole fractions or yi, and then we have the total pressure, which is 1 atmosphere. And we also have the K values, which we will read from D Priester's chart. And I've considered them as given because we're going to read them. And we're going to find the liquid mole fractions, like liquid mole fractions of the droplet over here. Like what composition does it have? Like how much of each component does it have when it's condensing? And we're going to find the dew point temperature. Now, it's the same iterative process where we first choose, like I explained before, for the bubble point calculation, where we choose a certain temperature and we have like a given total pressure, and then we draw a line connecting them, and then we read the K value, and then there's a certain condition that we check it against. If it equals to 1, then it means that our temperature is the dew point. If it doesn't equal to 1, then we follow another iteration and read other K values. We follow this loop. So this loop continues on forming until we get the dew point temperature. Now, what's different over here is this condition, and I'll explain why. And the same as for choosing the temperature, the same logic over here is used, that since like the vapors are condensing into liquid, the dew point needs to be between the boiling points, the two extreme boiling points, the boiling point of the most volatile and the least volatile components. And we need to choose a Ki, and we need to choose a temperature at which some of the Ki are larger than 1 and some of them are less than 1, so that this condition is satisfied. Now coming back to why we're picking this condition and how we're picking this condition, this is a little bit complicated, but not too much. Let me explain. So we know that the mole fractions of liquid and gas in a certain component must equal to 1, and we also know that the vapor and liquid have a relationship. Vapor liquid components have a relationship by this constant called Ki, which is the vapor liquid equilibrium constant. But since we're working with dew points, our Xi is not given. This is kind of out of the picture for now. This is not given. So we can only work with Yi's and Ki's. So what we do is we need to work with Yi and Ki. We can write Yi summation Yi over summation Ki is equals to summation Xi is equals to 1. Why should it equal to 1? Because the same component, the same logic applies over here. When you've got a mixture, maybe 5% of this is component 1. The rest, 25% is component 2. And 100 minus 30, 70. So the rest of the 70% needs to be component 3. And this, like all the components need to add up to 1. Hence, Xi is equals to 1, and Xi is equals to Yi over Ki. Since Xi is not given because we're working with dew point, we get to work with Yi, Ki. Okay, so this is why we need to satisfy this condition. Okay, now we choose the same procedure, the similar procedure to bubble point, where we choose a temperature, where I've chosen 5060 because it's giving me a nice distribution of Ki's. Some of them are larger than 1. Some of them are smaller than 1. And then I calculated this product, yi over the sum of product, actually, the quotient, yi over ki, which is 0.74. Now, since it's less than 1, the dew point is too high. The K value is too low. Since the K is in the denominator, if K gets lower, okay, the K value is too, like if K gets lower, this needs to increase. So we need to pick the K value of like our reference component, which I'm choosing as N-pentane, it needs to increase. So if K will increase, this will, the final product needs to increase up to 1. So we need to choose a lower temperature. At a lower temperature, as we go down, as we see the D-Priester chart, at a lower temperature, like we go down, 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 okay, the K value will decrease. And as the K value decreases, the K value decreases, this product will increase up to 1. So we need to choose a lower temperature. And this is our problem over here. Now, how do we, but you know, since this is an iterative process, it will just get too messy if we just choose on randoms. So we calculate a new K. Now, how do we calculate it? It's nothing too complicated, but let me explain again. So yi, we just deduced earlier that yi over ki ideally needs to equal to 1. So this is our new goal that we're, this is, I'm writing this as new because this is our goal. It needs to equal to 1. And then we have our previous yi ki. The previous yi ki, the one which we calculated from trial 1 or iteration 1. This one over here at t is equals to 56C. I'm writing this as old. Now when we multiply this by ki reference, I'm taking the reference component as the middle component, pentane. You can take it as any, you can, it can either be butane or hexane. I'm just taking this as pentane. So when I multiply ki nu, this is the equation I'm working with. Okay. This is the equation I'm working with. Now, when I, okay, now this value over here, this equals to 1 because ideally it needs to equal to 1 as in a normal mixture, all the vapor components and all the liquid components, they should all equal to 1. This is why this needs to equal to 1. And this is going to get cancelled and this is going to get cancelled. So we're left with yi is equals to yi. So this is the logic behind this derivation. However, when we're writing the derivation, since this value equal to 1, we decide to omit it. And we just only write ki of reference nu is equals to ki of reference nu comes here, ki of reference old multiply by the product of yi over ki old. And we use this formula over here to calculate, and we use this formula over here to calculate our k reference nu. And since this value was 0.74 over here, now we're gonna calculate k reference nu, k reference u using 0.74. So we multiply 0.74, we multiply 0.74 by k reference old. What is the, okay, so the ki value of n pentane was 1.85. Now we multiply 0.74 by 1.85 and then we get 1.37. So my new value is going to be, my new value for K is going to be 1.37. Now, what I'm going to do is I am going to draw a line. I'm going to draw a line, and this line I've decided to show in brown. My trial 2, I've decided to show in brown between 101.3 and 1.37. Let me magnify this. Let me zoom in really well. 1.37. Okay, since I'm working on computer, I have the advantage of zooming in, but when we're working on paper, we might not be as precise, and that's okay. So this is 1 over here, this is 1, this is 1.5, this one is 1.3, this one is 1.3, this one is 1.4. So 1.37 is going to be somewhere closer to 1.4, so I make a line between here and 101.3. So these are the two points I use to make a line, and then I extend it to find a temperature T2, which becomes 45 degrees C. Now, when I'm here, I read the K values for other components, butane and hexane. For butane, my value is around 4.35, Let me see how we got this value. So this is 5 over here, this is 4, this is 3. I realize this chart is a little bit hard to read because the lines are curved, but after some practice, it's going to be fine. So this one is 4.2 over here. This line is 4.4, then 4.6, 4.8, and 4.5. And we see our line is cutting somewhere very close to 4.4, but not exactly 4.4. So I've taken this as 4.35. Now coming to hexane, I've marked this line for hexane, so we have like a much more easy time looking through. So this is 0.4, this is 0.5, and our value is closer, very, very close to 0.5. So I've taken this as 0.48. So when I have my two K values over here, and my K value for the middle component, pentane, was 1.37. Now I have all of my K values. I can work on calculating the summation of the product. Okay, now I have the summation of my product here, which is Yi over Ki, and this I found as 1.036. Okay, now I want to do another iteration, and this and here my temperature comes out to be T is equals to 45. Actually, in exams, if your professor requires, you could just do one iteration, but for the sake of precision, I want to do another one because I want to bring my value as close to one. So I'm trying to reach a value which is closer, much closer to the real dew point temperature, as calculated through another program. Okay, since I'm trying to reach a much more precise value, I'll try to do another iteration, but sometimes mostly professors just ask for one iteration. Okay, now moving on, I'm going to multiply 1.036 multiply by 1.37, and then I get a new K value at 1.42. Okay, I get a new K value at 1.42. Now I will draw a line between 1.42 and 101.35. So 325. So this is my line, and this line is going to be yellow, and I've marked this as T3. So 101.3 and 1.42. Actually, this needs to be 1.42. So okay. So I'll need to. So I've drawn a line between 1.42 and 101.35. So the pentane one is the middle one. Let's spot 1.42. So this is 1.4 here. This is 1.5 here. So 1.42 comes somewhere over here, and this is where it hits our curve. So I'm gonna draw a line between 1.42 and 101.3, and then I'm just gonna extend this line, and once I extend this line, it comes and it hits my chart at 45, 46, at 47 degrees Celsius. Okay, so this is the temperature I get from the third iteration. Meanwhile, I'll also read the Ki values for the other two components. For butane, this turns out to be 4.5. This is 4, this is 5, and the yellow line cuts exactly in the middle, so I'm taking this as 4.5. And for the yellow line for hexane, it turns that it cuts at around 0. This is 0.5, this is 0.6, so it cuts at around 0.52. I'm taking this value as 0.52, and then we do another. No, actually, I'm taking this as around 0 because it's much closer to 0.51. Yeah, it's much closer than to 0.51. Okay, I'm taking this as 0.51 over here. Okay, and this value I've taken as 4.6. Yes, because it's a little bit much closer to 5. Once you magnify. Okay, I have magnified here, so you can read the values for yourself, and you can do these calculations by yourself. By the way, this chart was taken from IK website, and this website is public, and it's publicly available. So you can feel free to do your own calculations, and let me know if you're getting the same answers. And then we got 4.6, 1.4, 0.51. I calculated the product, and I calculated the summation of the product. Now we see 0.9889 is much closer to 1 than 1.036. So my value I have gotten is much closer. Now I can say that 47 degrees Celsius is much more precise than, much more closer to the real value than 45 degrees Celsius. And I can do another iteration, but it's just going to be really hard because you see For my reference component, I'm running out of space to make a second line, especially when I'm working with paper. If I'm working on computer, so I could just make two closed lines, but when I'm working on paper, reading off of a chart, of a physical chart, even this gap, it's much harder to form. So this is a limitation of D. Priester's chart, is that you cannot get much closer. So this is the closest that I was able to get with D. Priester's chart, and I got the TUDU temperature as 47 degrees Celsius. When I put my YI values in the solver, in thermosolver, I got 47.5, so I'm confident that this is pretty close. And the question also asked me to solve for liquid mole fractions. And now I know, as I wrote over here, that YI over KI is equals to XI, which is liquid mole fractions. And subsequently, we have been calculating liquid mole fractions in all of the last columns. So this is my dew point. So this is my final iteration, which I'm going to choose. And this is my dew point. My dew point is T is equals to 47C. And I have chosen, and these are the liquid mole fractions that I've calculated. So let's say if this gaseous mixture condenses and forms, let's say this is a very bad drawing of a liquid droplet, and then let's say it forms certain droplets. So 53% of that droplet is going to be N-butane, 38% of that droplet is going to be N-pentane, and 7.5% of that droplet is going to be hexane. So these are the liquid mole fractions, and I have calculated them. Hopefully you found this tutorial helpful, and if you have more questions, please let me know, and please comment on my teaching in the comments. I would love to get feedback from you all. Thank you.